Hi everyone. After showing you how to build a dynamic shopping cart in Glide, I now want to show you how to build a clickable image gallery in Glide Pages. So a quick showcase of or a quick demo of what I'm talking about. So here I have a list of items, and each of these items has a few images. Now, what I mean by a clickable image gallery is if I click the second picture will become the bigger picture, or it will be shown as a bigger picture. I click on the first picture, is the first picture, the third picture is the third picture. But not only that, if I simply click on the bigger picture, it keeps circling through the list of images that I have. Going back to the first item in this list, the behavior is similar. So I keep on clicking the bigger picture. It circles through all the available pictures, and I can randomly select any of these smaller pictures, which will be then shown as a bigger picture and also as a picture in the title bar. So this is what I'm talking about when I say clickable image gallery in Glide Pages. And to show you how this is set up, it's very simple. Now, this collection here is a container. Let me come up out of the preview. This here is a container. It's a 2:1 container. The first picture, the first one is a bigger picture. The second half of the container contains three smaller pictures. Now the action for each of these is a little different, but before we look at why I have set those actions in a certain way, let's look at what's happening in the background. So I'll go to the data editor view. Here for each item, I have three image fields, image one, image two, image three. For each item, I have a user specific field called index, which I set when you click each of those individual images in that gallery view, or when you click on the bigger picture to increment this number. And you can keep on incrementing this number, but what we essentially need is the modulus of the index. And now, because I'll show you how this is configured, the modulus is the mod of index, and the argument for the modulus is the number of images that we have. So right now, because we have three images, this number is three. If we have four images, this number will be four. So basically, the output of this column is always going to be 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2. And now based on that value, I have an if then else column that outputs which image should be shown as part of the bigger or the zoomed in picture. So if the mod is 0, show image 1. If the mod is 1, show image 2. If the mod is 2, show image 3. As I said, if there are four pictures, then there will also be another condition for mod equals 3, and then you show image 4. And if it's none of this, these 0, 1, 2, which will be the case when you enter a new item in this list, then we simply show image 1. Now, going back to how each of these conditions is configured. So when I click on the bigger picture, I'm simply circling through the list of images. So here in this case, what I've done is I simply increment the index by 1. But if I click on these individual images, I hard set the value of the index to 0, 1, 2. So for example, if I'm clicking on image 1, the action here is set column values in this item to 0. For image 2, it will be set column values in this item to 1. And for the third one, it will be to 2. And similarly, in the title bar here, I'm showing the output image instead of image 1, 2, or 3. So this is what this quick tutorial or this how-to video is about. It's about creating a clickable image gallery in Glide Pages. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, let me know what other videos you would like me to create. If you have any queries about Glide, my number is in the description below. My WhatsApp link is in the description below. You can talk to me about this configuration. You can ask me your questions about Glide, and you can also submit requests about what more videos I could create. That's all for now. I'll speak to you soon. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.